Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So don't forget to like, subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified on when I make a new video. So today, instead of playing Roblox, I am actually going to be making a crossbow by using office supplies. So for this video, you will need an elastic band, which can be replaced by a rubber band, a pen grip, the same ink of that little pen which you took the grip off. However, you need to empty out the ink of the pen. You need 4 pencils, 2 of which have to be separate and 2 of which have to be stuck together by tape. You need a usual roll of Scotch Brite cello tape or whatever you think. And you will need a box of usual supplies that most of you all must be having at home, in which there are paper clips. The paper clips are here, the U-pins, rubber bands and pins. So you won't be needing the pins and the U-pins here, you will be needing only the rubber bands and the paper clips. Okay? So you will need one paper clip and a whole lot of rubber bands, including this one. So I'm saying an elastic band because this is what will be used to fire the arrow out of the crossbow. Which, if you all didn't know, the ink is the arrow. So basically, if you can see here, the elastic band covers the ink completely. So when you pull it, it stays on. However, if you take a rubber band, it doesn't cover the ink. And there's a whole lot of a chance that it might slip off very, very quickly. Because it is like this. So it doesn't even stay. It'll just slip off and then hit you in your hand when you're loading it. So that's why, but of course right now we're in the quarantine and there's lockdown and everything that's coming up the second phase. So you don't really necessarily need this thing. You can use a rubber band. But then for that, you need to heat up a knife. Tell your parents to do this. Do not do this yourself. You need to heat up a knife and place it on this. So the knife will burn through the plastic and will make a place in which you can shove the rubber band in. And saying it again, do not do this yourself. You can hurt yourself very bad if you take a hot knife in your own hand. Please tell your parents to do this for you if you do not have an elastic band. Also, if you know you have many friendship bands at home, if you like hoard them at home, if you have a huge stash of it, you can take a friendship band and keep on doing this for like some time. And in the end, it will become very, very stretchy. And then you can use the friendship band itself. But it should be the friendship band that's this thin, not the fat ones that you usually get. Anyways, without any further ado, let's continue making our item. So, as I said before, these two you need to pre-make. You need to just take 2 new pencils and stick them together using cello tape. These 2 pencils need to be stuck together, not cello tape, but using rubber bands. Take a rubber band and put it on one end of it. And make it as tight as you can. It should not be movable. It should be completely unmovable. Because if it moves, then your arrow might get very out of order. And if somebody's walking by, something bad is going to happen. So you need to tighten it a whole lot. As much as possible, in fact. I'm tightening it more than necessary. Because I'm going to not take any chances right now. Anyways. It's flat on the top. It has to be flat on the top because they're going to be this way and it should be flat, otherwise it's not going to look awesome. Anyways, on the other end, you're going to take another rubber band. It doesn't really matter what color it is, it just needs to tighten well. Also, you should use a small rubber band for this because if you use a long rubber band, it'll take up more area. And you might not need that because you need to add a lot of stuff to this. Not a lot, but you need as much place as you can get. So as I did here, you need to do it this way. It should be absolutely unmovable, as even though how much of pressure I put, it doesn't move. So you need to put both of these like this. You need to put it in such a way that it's like this. And the pencil should be on the bottom end and it should be flat on top. So that the ink will be here. The paper clip will be here. Which will be tied on my rubber band. Here will be the grip of the pen. And the rubber band will be from here to here. So you can either choose to use the rubber band and to make the rubber bands. But mostly you should use the tape and to put the rubber bands. Because tape is a bit stronger than the rubber bands. So tie it like this. So our elastic band will come from here like this, and it will stretch up to here. So we will be putting that a whole lot later actually. So just need to stick it like this first using rubber bands. So this is the hardest part of the video, because well, it's really really hard to do this, because I'm having a lot of trouble to do it, because the problem is that when you put the rubber bands, that's one different thing only, because when you put the rubber bands, it basically turns like this, as you can see. And this looks really really weird. It has to turn to be like this. That's why we're gonna be putting other rubber bands. So this rubber band snapped, as you can see. That's a problem. But luckily I have more. You need to be more careful, because you might not be having a whole set of them at home like I do. So you need to do it again. So first, before you do that, I think you should stretch it like this. The more you stretch it, the more it becomes stretchy, as you can see here. And when it becomes the end, it's more stretchy than ever. That's where you can use it better, like this. Now we will try to do it, and let's see if it snaps again or not. So it's really tight, but I'm trying. Anyways, it's done, I guess. And now, as you can see guys, it is perfectly straight. It's not even a bit slanting. So that's really good. Now we will be using the paper clip. So the paper clip isn't really very important, because the thing is that you can use it as a simple bow and arrow, by which I mean you can. So we're just gonna be sticking this like this. I'm not really sticking it right now, but I'm just showing you. So this grip will basically come here, and then the ink will come from here like this. So if you can, as a bow and arrow I'm saying, you can hold the ink like this, pull it back and fire. So right now I'm not gonna fire because nothing's in place, but I was just showing it to you. However, when you put a paper clip, whatever that may be, here, if the paper clip's here, we will stick it somewhere like this. And when you pull it behind, it will get connected to the paper clip like a trigger. And then when you press it down, it will fire. So that's the best thing, because it actually looks like a crossbow. Otherwise, you can use it this way and make it a bow and arrow like how Hawkeye does it. Anyways, we're going to be doing it my way, which means we're going to be putting the paper clip. First, before the paper clip, the most important part of the project is the grip. Without the grip, it's impossible to fire. And even if it fires, it might not go straight. Might not, it will not go straight. So this, you need to be very careful with this part. You need to tie it firmly, of course, but lightly. By lightly, I mean you should not play to push too much pressure on the grip, because grips, as you know, they're not very powerful and they can be pressed down very easily. So you need to make sure that they are still round, because this is the main thing. And our pencil, the pen ink will be going like this. And when we pull it back, the rubber band and fire, it will go ahead like that. The next part of this is putting our paper clip. So paper clip, you can play right now, you can put it, or more recommendedly, you can put it a little later, by which you will know where you will have to stick the paper clip. Because if you stick it right now, you'll have to make a lot of adjustments whole later on. However, if you want, you can stick it now to make it easier for you. Because if you do later, it'll be quite difficult to put the paper clip. I'm sorry, I'm so just saying play. I keep on saying play for everything. Anyways, now I will stick the rubber band into the paper clip. So you need to do this. Put it into the gap of the paper clip. It's not very hard to do, but it's not the easiest thing either. So you need to press it and put the rubber band in there. So now you will put it from behind. Take it behind like this. And put it below the pencil. Now we'll have to put it in the middle. And when we put it in the middle, we will put it downwards. Tie it into a knot and pull it here. Turn it, pull it. Turn it, pull it. And turn it and put it. Make it as tight. tight as possible, because if it's not tight, it will not work. That's 100% assurance from my end. But this is as tight as it gets. Now we need to test if it works. So mine's working pretty well, and I'm quite happy with it. And as you can see, it looks really similar. Only thing over here, I've used sellotape to make the... If you don't have a grip, you can use sellotape to make your arrow holder. You can just put your finger in and tie the sellotape around it. And then pull your finger out, of course. Now, here. We can see this. It's ready. Now, all we need to do is put this rubber band over here for the final amount. Put it around this place and then hold it in here. Otherwise, it'll snap and it'll hurt you in your hand. And then put it on this side. Then try to stick this in between so it doesn't come out. And it's ready. Now all we need to do is use it. So the loading is a problem because it's really hard to do. Anyways, we will put it down here and pull it behind towards the paperclip. And put it in the paperclip and make the paperclip hold it down, and we are ready to fire. And as you saw, you can't even see it on camera. So it's super, super fast. And you might not be able to find the ink later on, but I have found it. We will load it again. I'll try to make it into slow motion and let's see how it works. Put it in the ink, pull it behind, put it in here, and fire. As you saw, it went at such a speed, it hit the wall and came back to me. That is how powerful this thing is. And do not hit it at any human being, because it will be really, really painful. If you like this video and it's helpful and the crossbow works for you, do not forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon to get notified when I make a new video. Until next time, goodbye, and see you in my next video, which will not be an art and craft video. It will be a Roblox gaming video. Bye, guys.